Hello, basketball coaches and basketball players. My name is Alan from Al's Basketball Training, and today I'm going to give you some press break basketball plays that you can use at the middle school level. Let's get down to the clipboard and let's check these out. Okay, so first we have a press break against a diamond defense. What we're going to have is player two setting a screen for player one, and player one is going to be popping down towards that baseline. Player 3 is going to pass him the ball, and that's going to now bring player 1 up. What we want to see now is player 2 to get himself free, and player 3 now to go up this sideline. At this time, we want player 2 to get that ball from player 1, and now what's going to happen is player 1 and player 3 and 2 are going to be kind of gathering together, because now we have basically beat the press. And what I mean by that is we have the ball up the middle, and we have a clear path past half court, and they're going to try and cut off that path, and when they do that, that's going to open up the sideline to player three as well as the sideline to player one. Now at this time, we don't usually like going up the sideline. You want to stay inside the volleyball court. However, if you have a clear path past half court away from the trap areas, then you take it. Whichever one of these players your player two feels more confident in, he can pass them the ball. And now player five is in scramble mode. We have player three in scramble mode. We also have player one in scramble mode. And when that happens, it's good times. What we want is, if player four is smart, he might be the only smart player at this time, because we don't want players scrambling, and we definitely do not want player five scrambling to that side. He might be covering player five, and if he's not, you could go pass to player five. If it's a good pass and strong pass, he can definitely do that. However, we want player one to dribble past half court. And now, with player five and player three trying to trap down, we could now have player three open, which will allow player three to now either get an open shot or go 3-on-1 against player four. Now, this press also works really well against a man-to-man full court press defense. I'm not going to show that. Actually, I will. Let's go do that right now. So we're going to have player 2 setting a screen for player 1. Player 1 is going to pop down towards underneath the basket, and player 1 is then going to be recovering, and player 1, blue, has the ball. Next, we're going to have player 2 setting a screen on player 1, or if player 3 is fast enough, faster than his defender, he could just get that ball, and now we can be running running up the court and having fun. Now, of course, as you've seen, player 2 isn't popping out towards the middle. The reason is this is a man-to-man defense, and instead of popping to the middle, he's setting a screen for player one, so that if player three is not faster than his man, player one is able to then dribble up the court and get past his defender, even if player two was popping out on him. And if he did beat him, player two, blue, can be rolling towards the basket and again get the ball up the middle. Makes life a lot easier. Okay, so this next press break, I'm going to be showing it against a 1-2-2, because that's another pretty often used press defense. So what we're going to start with is player 2 again setting a screen for player 1. Player 1 is going to be using that screen, and of course I'm going to just showing you this quickly against a 1-2-2. This is the same press that we just used. Player 2 is going to pop towards the middle. Player 2 is going to receive that pass. That's going to collapse the defense. And we're going to have player 1 and 3 running up the sidelines, giving open lanes. Once one of those players gets it, they're going to be trying to smother him down the middle. And that's going to be now offering player 2 to do one of two things. He can cut downfield or down the court. He can receive that pass and set up the offense. Or what he can do is set a screen on player 2. And player one is going to use that screen, and again, same thing, pass down the middle. Okay, so now in our second press break of the day, what we're going to be using is a quick screen for player one, red, or instead, no, delete. Okay, so now in our next press, what we're going to be having is player 2 and player 1 both cutting down towards the baseline. If player 1 continues down but is not covering either one, player 3 can pass to player 2 or player 1, depending on who's better open. If player 1 is quick and he can cut off that pass, I really want that press or that pass to go to player 2. Now, once player 2 gets that ball, we want player 1 to go up and guard him, And now we also want player 3 instead to go up that left side, the opposite side he passes to. There's a reason for this. The reason is now player 2 is going to be using player 1 as a screen, and that's going to be collapsing player 3 on him, and player 1 is also going to be trying to force him towards the sideline. Now what's going to be happening is it's allowing us to now get the ball possibly into player 4 at the middle court, and player 1 is going to be running up the sideline, and we can now have one of two things happening. Player 4 can now turn around and set up the offense. He can also be looking for player 5 cutting across the key. As soon as that ball gets past half court, in the center of the court, we want player 5 to be moving across the key, because this could get us a quick basket, especially if player 5 is focusing on player 1 and player 4 is focusing on the player at half court. Now, what can happen as well is player 4 could also pass to player 3 or player 1, because now we technically have a 4-on-2 advantage on this defense. There's an advantage to having a press defense, and that is if you're quick enough, you can trap players along the sidelines. But the downfall is if you have a properly ran press break, you can get some mismatches happening like this one right here. Now against a man-to-man defense, again, very simple. Both players are going to be running down towards the baseline, and most likely player 2 is going to be the player who is going to be getting that ball. We now want player 1 setting a screen on player 3. Player 3 is going down court, and he could be open down court. We are also going to now have player 1, he is going to be setting a screen on player 2 as well, just like before. And we're going to be having player 2 now dribble up court. Now, if there's no switch, and if this was a very strong screen, we could have a 4-on-2 advantage once again. Now, let's go see it against a diamond defense. Now, against the diamond defense, once again, you can pass to either side. Most likely, it's going to be player 2, and player 1 is going to be moving up on him. Player 1 is going to be setting that screen, and player 3 is going to be going up the opposite side of where he passed. And we're going to be now having player 2 dribbling up, and now that's going to collapse player 2 on this diamond defense. Now, we're going to be having player 1 trying to fight through. Of course, they're trying to cut off the middle. Now, one of a few things is going to happen. He can pass to player 3, and we can be on a 3-on-2 advantage. Or, if player 4 starts sneaking over because he sees player 3 cutting up the side, and he's not experienced enough to remember that we want nothing up the middle, then what we can have is player 2 passing to player 4, and player 4 can now set up the offense because now we've got it up past half court. And he can even drive right towards the basket, draw player 5 red out to defend him. He can pass to player 5 for a layup. So again, properly ran press breaks will allow you to have nice baskets like that one. So just recapping this last press break, we're having both of these players cut down. One of those players will be an option for player 3 to pass to. And then whichever side he passes to, if he passes to player 2, he's going to be cutting up that side. If he passes to player 1, he's going to be cutting up this side. And the whole plan is to either get the ball up the middle or get player 4 to catch it in the middle, or to try and beat the middle so that we have open lanes up the sideline so that we can run our offense or set up our 3-on-2, 3-on-1, 4-on-2, whatever we have down on this end.
I hope that these basketball plays help your team win more games. If they do, let us know in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys again later on today for another basketball video.